Thanks for joining us again at the Azure Academy. Today we have another new creator to introduce you all to, and Phil Gibson is someone who I worked with on the Fast Track team for a couple years, and now he's moved on to be part of the product group. So this is a very special video, and Phil is going to cover things around containers, Kubernetes, open source, and I'm sure several other things as we go on. So thanks for joining us, Phil. Take it away.
Thanks, Dean. Are you operating a containerized computing environment where you need the ability to securely manage your microservices communication, easily manage access policies, and quickly get access to visualize all of your telemetry metrics? Today, I'm going to introduce and help you deploy Open Service Mesh. I am Phil Gibson, and this is the Azure Academy.
If you want to master the Azure Cloud, you can start right now by clicking the subscribe button and the notification bell so you don't miss anything.
Before we get into the Open Service Mesh demo, it's first to get a good understanding of the Service Mesh Interface specification, commonly known as the SMI spec. This specification is the guiding principle for the architecture of Open Service Mesh. At the heart of the SMI specification is a standard for all service meshes to universally provide a common portable set of APIs for the most common capabilities of a service mesh, such as traffic policy, traffic telemetry, and traffic management. Just so we're on the same page, let's talk about where a service mesh fits into a containerized computing environment. You can think of a container as an operating system kernel level virtualization. This is where there is one operating system and the operating system has a kernel that runs everything. So containers will typically have less operational overhead and less cost over traditional hardware virtualization solutions. So since we are in the cloud, the next obvious question is, how can I deploy and manage containers at scale to managing hundreds or even thousands? This is where we need an orchestrator. And as of today, the open source project Kubernetes is the most popular. Azure has a Kubernetes service solution called AKS, which stands for, you guessed it, Azure Kubernetes Service, which we will be getting into later in this series. For now, what's important to understand for today's talk is that Kubernetes has the concept of a pod, which can be a managed group of containers. And this is where we will dig in for today's talk about service meshes. Service meshes are used to control and authorize traffic to containers in pods in what is popularly known as a sidecar pattern. This at a high level means that there is a company container separate from your application's container. By separating the communications functions from the application, this allows app developers to do what they do best, which is develop awesome applications, and the service mesh to take care of proxying traffic to the rest of the world. With all that said, Microsoft released a new project into the open source community, which is called Open Service Mesh, and I'm going to help you deploy this today. So I'm here on the openservicemesh.io page. Let's click the GitHub link, and that'll take us over to our OSM repo. And if we scroll down, we'll see the actual table of contents, and we actually have a link here called demos. If you're ready to jump in and just start using OSM, you can use the automated demo. Today is really me walking you through the manual demo and providing context where you need it. First thing we're going to do is let's go ahead and grab a clone of this repo locally, and I'm going to put this into my GitHub directory. Okay, so now that I have that local repo. And then the next thing we're going to do is we're going to grab the latest release. So as of today, that's going to be version 0.2.0. And since I'm using the WSL, I'll grab the Linux AMD 64 link to the tar file. I will go to my downloads directory and bring this down. And now let's just go ahead and unpack this. And now let me go ahead and just move this over to my path so I could just reference this anywhere on my system. And let me just type OSM. And there you go. So I got OSM in my path. Now let's go back to the repo. Let's click on the demos over to the manual demo. And again, this is our OSM manual demo guide. So we're essentially just going to walk through this. And again, I'm just going to provide you some context, hopefully make everything clear for you. A couple of housekeeping things. Just make sure you meet all the prerequisites. It's essentially sure that you have a Kubernetes cluster that's 1.15 or greater, that you have kube control, and then that you're focused on that cluster. And then this last bullet we've already done, we've already got our repo. So now let's go ahead and install OSM with the OSM install command. And that's it. So now we actually have OSM installed into our Kubernetes cluster. And what I could do is I could just check the pods into the OSM system namespace. We have four pods that were actually deployed. The OSM controller is OSM. And then you'll see that we have a Grafana and a Prometheus pods. Later on in this demo, we'll actually show some of the out-of-the-box dashboards that we have using Grafana and the Prometheus scrapes from the metrics. And then last, we have a Zipkin pod, and that pod is basically grabbing the metrics projects that are going to showcase in our UI for our demo bookstore application here. Now that we have OSM installed, let's go ahead and create the necessary namespaces for the bookstore application. We have our little for loop here that's going to create the bookstore, the book buyer, the book thief, and the book warehouse. And then now what we're going to do is we're going to onboard those namespaces to the OSM mesh. Essentially what this is doing is once we onboard a namespace to OSM, no pod communication from a service-to-service perspective is going to happen in that namespace. So that's by design. You're going to need to have policies deployed for your services to talk. If that's not the experience that you want, there actually is a flag on the OSM install called the Enable Permissive Traffic Policy. And essentially what that'll do is pods that are deployed in a OSM-enabled namespace, they'll still get the Envoy sidecar injected, but we won't have any policy enforcement. Let's go ahead and onboard namespaces to OSM. And there we go. Namespaces are OSM-enabled. Now, the next thing we're going to do is now we're going to deploy our bookstore application demo app. And so that's going to be in the docs example manifest apps directory. So I'm just going to copy and paste all of this. So now that we have our bookstore application installed, and let's talk about really what happens. As of now, there's four application services that got installed. There's the book buyer, the book thief, bookstore V1 service, and the book warehouse. And then essentially what this application is showing is that book buyer and book thief need to talk to bookstore V1, which is then fetching books out of the warehouse. So we're going to basically enable this whole communication, allow and deny thing based with OSM policies. These are all internal services to the cluster. They don't have any external endpoints. So the way that we're going to reach these UIs is actually through a port forwarding script that we've developed. The first thing that we're going to need to do to run this port forwarding script is to actually copy this environment example file over to .env to know which namespaces to enable the port forwarding to. Since we're going to be proceeding with the demo and still need to have connections into these applications to kind of show all the UI, it's actually best for us to go ahead and create that port forwarding in a separate terminal session so that those connections stay persistent and then we can continue on with the demo in the other terminal here. So now that we have that going, let's go ahead and open up some browsers and just make sure that we can see some of the services show up here. So we have our book buyer and we have our bookstore V1. And then last but not least is our book thief. So as you'll notice, there's no metrics happening because there's really no policies that have been deployed. And in fact, let me go and show you. And if we just do a kube control, when you install OSM, obviously there's some CRDs that are created, and the resources that we're really going to be concerned about and working with today are the traffic targets, among the others. But the traffic targets are really what you're telling the mesh who can talk to who. So if we go and we just look at our traffic targets right now, you'll see that there are no traffic targets, and hence why there's kind of no activity happening from the book buyer being able to talk to the bookstore, fetching that from the book warehouse. So the next step is for us to actually start to lay down these OSM policies to allow that traffic to start happening. Let's go ahead and deploy our SMI access control policies. We had a traffic target as well as a HTTP route group installed. Now, if we go back and kind of look at our traffic targets, you'll see that we have one traffic target that's in the bookstore called bookstore V1. And if we go ahead and describe that, we have our traffic target. Who can talk to it is actually the book buyer. So the book buyer, we are enabling the book buyer service to actually talk to the bookstore V1 service. And so now if I go back to the book buyer, we now see the increments happening from purchases from the bookstore. Now, if we go to the book thief, he has not had any policy applied to him, so he is denied to talk to the bookstore V1 service. Let's go ahead and now start to allow the book thief to start stealing some books out of the book warehouse. To do that, we just simply need to edit this traffic access YAML. Let's go ahead and open that up in the terminal, and we'll go into our docs example manifest access, and then we're going to look at the traffic access YAML. Here's the actual traffic target policy allowing currently the book buyer to speak to the bookstore V1 service, and what we have commented out is the actual book thief. So let's go ahead and allow the book thief to start stealing books, and then all we have to do now is just apply this. Now that that's applied, let's go back and look at our traffic target. And now you see that we have both the book buyer and the book thief able to talk to Bookstore V1. One other thing I want to show before we move on is the HTTP route groups. One thing to understand, what the HTTP route group is doing is, now that we've allowed the service-to-service communication via the traffic targets, there's an extra layer that we can basically provide policy for, which is the type of traffic that we want to allow to go across from service-to-service. In this case, this is all HTTP traffic, but if it was something other than HTTP, different TCP port, etc., you would have to define this here with the HTTP route group. Now let's go ahead and deploy that second service, and then we will talk about the traffic split, which is basically shifting that service where it's currently going to Bookstore V1 and moving it over to Bookstore V2. Let's go ahead and deploy Bookstore V2 service. Once we enable the Bookstore V2 service, what we'll need to do is first stop our port forwarding activities and then restart them again to establish that new connection. And there we go. Now we see that our Bookstore V2 is now online. It's not selling any books because, again, all the traffic is going to Bookstore V1 service. We basically only have one backend, which is the Bookstore V1 service, and it's weighted 100% of the traffic. So let's go ahead and now shift 100% of that traffic to the Bookstore V2 service. If I go back to Bookstore V1, we shouldn't see any more increments here because neither the book buyer or the book thief is able to talk to it since all the traffic is shifted off to Bookstore V2. You still will see the book buyer increment and also the book thief increment because essentially they're going through the Bookstore V2 service now. And then if we go to Bookstore V2, it is keeping up with the books sold from the warehouse now. And then last, what we're going to show you is really the out-of-the-box dashboards that you can get via the SMI spec. So we were very easily able to have Grafana pull metrics from OSM about activities that are happening in the mesh. To do this, let's go ahead and stop our port forwarding. The OSM dashboard command will actually automatically kick off port forwarding for us to get to the Grafana endpoint. Let's go ahead and run the OSM dashboard command. Now that's up and running. So now we just need to go to localhost 3000. And here we are at our Grafana page. And for the demo, the password is just admin admin. Now we're in the Grafana dashboard. Let's go ahead to the home screen. And what you'll see is we have a couple of directories here with some dashboards. So we have the OSM control plane, as well as the data plane. This is the OSM pod to service metrics. You'll see that we have some data here. We just deployed this, so some of this is not gonna show as of yet, but it will trickle in. And lastly, let's go ahead and look at the OSM control plane metrics. And this is showing our request count for HTTP and failure count, as well as some traffic to control plane and active connections to the control plane as well. So hopefully you found this helpful and can see how easy it was to get OSM installed and configured. If you have any questions or run into any issues, feel free to post issues on the OSM repo. And if there's any other scenarios you would like to see, please post that feedback as well. Also, if you want to contribute and make OSM better, please do. This is a community project and we love to have your participation in making OSM better. And please don't forget to keep checking back and join us for the rest of the series. Let us know in the comments what you would like to see in a series around Kubernetes or any other open source projects we're involved in. We'd love to hear from you. If you want to keep the learning going, check out the latest video on the top right, or watch one of the other videos we have picked just for you. Keep safe out there and enjoy your learnings.